G'day guys, welcome back to another Match Day vlog. Today I will be going back to Optus Stadium to watch Fremantle take on the Geelong Cats in retro round. Now to summarise up recent events, Fremantle have come off a very disappointing loss to the Essendon Bombers at the MCG. We were up by like 25 points early in the fourth quarter and then they just steamrolled us. They kicked like 5 goals in a row from centre clearances and we just lost control of that game. And even when Giannis kicked the last goal of the game, the scores were levelled and they destroyed us in the clearance again and they kicked it behind to win the game, which means that our top 4 hopes have sunken and we have to win all our 3 remaining games of the home and away season to finish in the top 4. Otherwise, if we lose at least one more game from here on, I just can't see ourselves making the top 4, which means I can't see ourselves winning the premiership this year because we really need top 4, especially as a Perth-based team. Geelong Cats, however, have come off a nail-biting win against the Adelaide Crows last week and they're looking to make the top 4 as well. So it'll be a very interesting battle here, both teams fighting for a top 4 spot and potentially top 8 even, because even we haven't solidified a top 8 spot just yet. We could miss out on finals altogether, but I really want top 4. So anyway, there's about a couple hours left before bounce down, so I thought I'd maybe stop by KFC and have a little lunch before I head off to the game. Go Frio! Just finished lunch, now off to Optus Stadium. Kicker Josh Tracy will not be playing today due to a knee injury, I believe, so that's very unfortunate. But nevertheless, I'm going to back in Fremantle to win this crucial game by 20 points. And I reckon all crowd attendance will have 46,482 people. Come on, Dockers. Down underway. Jeremy Cameron to kick the first goal of the game. I'm very worried about this player. Arguably Geelong's best forward. Jeremy Cameron. He's got it. And that's one very loud Geelong crowd. Must be a lot of Cat supporters here. Wow. He's got a, gave away a controversial holding the ball free kick there. I don't know why, but Ollie Henry now has a set shot on goal, and to make this 3 goals straight, should have been a high tackle. I don't know why that was holding the ball, and to put it through, this is already looking very concerned. Jeez. Oh, hit the post.
Bloody hell.
Come on, Sturty. Oh my gosh. Come on. Come on, Mark. Yeah! Much needed. Sorry, I missed it on camera. For some reason, I pressed the wrong button on camera, but Caleb Strong just kicked that goal. Yeah, from Sam Sturt, and then Caleb Strong marked it. And show you. Yeah, puts it through. Very sorry I missed that. I pressed the wrong button. Jordan Clark to try to kick a goal from about 50 metres. Maybe even more than 50 metres. Let's see what he's got. Alrighty, quarter time siren. I think that was a Geelong free kick, or Geelong mark, but anyway. It's quarter time now, my gosh. We've dropped so many marks in that first quarter. Could have potentially led to us kicking more goals or us saving more goals. But anyway, we're only down by 13 points now. After Geelong kicked the first three goals, we really, really need to step up here in the second quarter if we want to win this game, and also more importantly to keep our top four hopes and premiership hopes alive. Go Frio. Michael Frederick to kick the first goal in the second quarter. What will this be? Kick this. And he has put it through! Go Freddy! Go Frio! Sam Sturt has a set shot on goal here to level the scores from a relatively tight angle. It's gonna be. I know you can do it. One set. You've got this. Yeah, he's put it through. Go, Sturton. Well done, Sturton. Neil has just taken a controversial mark. And this has kicked along their first goal, the second goal of the second term. Cats get one back. Alright, that was the halftime siren. Alrighty, it's halftime now. That was a bit better by us, I reckon, this quarter. I mean, a few umpire calls didn't go our way that were quite controversial, you know, which they didn't help. But nevertheless, I thought we did pretty well in this quarter. We're only trailing by 6 points. Still a half of football to go. I reckon we can definitely win this now, after it looked like Geelong were going to destroy us early in that first quarter. But yes, anyway, hopefully we continue to step up our game, make the most of our opportunities. I know the absence of Josh Tracy is really hurting us, I know. But even without Josh Tracy, I still have that belief in us. We're still good enough to beat the best teams in the conference. Two more quarters to go. Top four spot on the line. Premiership on the line. Let's go, Dockers. Luke Jackson with a set shot and goal to level the scores once again. And put the first goal in the third quarter. Phillips are on with another set shot and goal here.
Got the journey. He
has! Let's go, well done. We've now taken the lead for the first time in this match. Go, Frio. Diana with a set shot and goal to take back the lead. What is this going to be? Come on, Amos. Got this. Yeah!
Okay, the three-quarter time siren has just sounded, and we are currently winning by 4 points, just 4 points. I reckon this is going to go down to the wire like the previous Fremantle game, but hopefully this time we pick up the win. We really need to redeem ourselves after what happened last week. Okay, it's absolute must. If we lose one more game from here on, we're done. We're out of top four. And this is also to help us secure our top eight spot as well, you know. Crucial. So anyway, just got to keep out our efforts. Hope we play right until the very end. Hopefully the players don't do what we did in the last quarter of the Essendon game. And yeah, hopefully we take home the dub and get back in the top four. Go Frio. And Dangerfield now with a set to the goal to finally back the lead for the Cats. Finally get back the lead for Geelong. Hopefully you soon. Guy Amos has another shot on goal here. This to take back the lead. What is this going to be? Come on, Guy. We really need to kick this. We've got this, Guy.
A few moments later.
The ball! And Geelong should be winning this game now. Unbelievable. Alrighty. We don't have much time left. I think it's realistically over. Come on, 3-0. Geelong mark. It's a Geelong mark. I just don't know what to feel now. Oh, come on, Freya. But we're not going to make the top four, and we might not even make the top eight after being inside the top eight throughout pretty much the whole season. It's very devastating. And I don't think we have enough time. I can't even describe my pain. It hurts a lot. But yeah, because we've lost today, it means, well, we are not going to make the top four now. And we might, I don't think we'll make top eight, because next week we take on the Giants at our NG Stadium. We've never won at that ground before. And they've just beaten the Lions at the Gabba. So what chances, what odds do we have of beating them there? And the following week we take on an informed Port Adelaide here. We might even lose that. And if we lose both those games, we should be knocked out of the top eight. So it's just devastating, because we have such a good list, you know. Like, I know Josh Tracy wasn't playing today, but we should we should be doing better than like what middle of the table, you know. We should be, we do have a top four team, I think. A great midfield, a solid defence, and our forward line is getting there, you know, with Jai Amos and Josh Tracy, you know. It's just so unlucky to not make finals, you know. But anyway, I think even if we like make the finals, I think we'll just be making up the numbers, because we finished 5th, 6th, 7th or 8th. Like, there's no way we're going to win the flag from there. I don't really care. Because we're not going to make the top four, I don't really care where we finish. I don't really care if we miss out on finals, because I don't want to make up the numbers. I want to go all the way, you know. And the only way we can realistically go all the way is we finish in the top four. So anyway, I'll be heading back home now. Well played, Geelong. They can win another premiership from here. That should be finishing inside the top four this year. I don't know what to make of our season. We had such a... Things are going so well for us, you know. And it's very unfortunate we're probably going to miss out on the top eight altogether. Yeah, it hurts a lot. But anyway, I'll be back here in 2 weeks' time for the final, which will probably be my final vlog for this year. We take on the Power. Hopefully we win that, but it's just really disappointing we couldn't make the top four again, and probably won't make top, as I've already said, we won't make the top eight again. Anyway, I hope you all have a great weekend. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit that like button, and if you haven't already, please click that subscribe button. It means the world to me. And yes, feel free to leave a comment down below. Yes, ring that notification bell. And of course, feel free to share this video to anyone. I'll be wrapping up the vlog here. I hope you had a great weekend. I hope you have a great week. And I will see you all next time. Go Frio.